In this video, we will show you how to add and configure your microphone in Elgato Wave Link. We've created chapters in this video for sections like the basics of controlling your mic to more advanced controls, and finally, how to add and use third-party microphones. Check in the description or on the video player timeline to skip to the information that you're looking for. To start out, you will need Elgato Wave Link installed. You can find the latest version from our downloads page at elgato.com/downloads. When you first open Wave Link, your Wave device is added automatically as an input, and you'll see activity on the meter at the top and bottom as you talk. However, if you only see this screen, this means Wave Link doesn't detect a Wave device connected. To unlock Wave Link, you will need a Wave Neo, Wave 1, Wave 3, Wave XLR, XLR dock, or a Stream Deck Plus connected to your PC or Mac. At the top of the input channel for your Wave device, you'll find a large button that activates the hardware mute, the same one you'll find on your Wave microphone. Click on the down arrow at the top of the microphone channel to expose all the settings for your Wave device. First, you'll see a real-time level meter showing the sound coming from your Wave device. Below this is gain control. Microphone gain is the amount of amplification happening inside of your Wave device. Higher gain equals a louder sound, but can expose more background noise. The amount to choose depends on how loud you speak, how close you are, the type of microphone, and more. If you are using Wave 3 or Wave 1, try 20 decibels. If you are using Wave DX with Wave XLR or XLR dock, try 45 decibels. This can be changed at any time. As an example, this voiceover was recorded at 47 decibels of gain on an XLR dock with Wave DX. Once you find a gain value that works, you generally never need to touch it again, unless you change one of those factors mentioned before, like your microphone, distance, or how you speak. If you are using XLR dock or Wave XLR, you will see a toggle for 48-volt phantom power next. Phantom power is required for certain types of microphones like condenser-type microphones. You will want to check with the information for your specific XLR microphone to know whether you should or should not use 48-volt phantom power. Next is controlling what you hear through the headphone port on your Wave device. Output volume is the overall volume of the headphone port itself. Mic/PC mix controls the balance between the zero latency monitoring from your microphone and the sound coming from your PC or Mac. If you want to hear your voice in your headphones with no latency, you must make sure that the slider is somewhere to the left. If you don't want to hear yourself at all, make sure this is all the way to the right at 100% PC. Once you've dialed in the gain, headphone output, and mic/PC mix, you can go ahead and add your microphone to your voice chat apps or get to recording. Choose Elgato Mic In for the input on any of those apps, and Elgato Headphones for the output. There are some further advanced options to cover though. On some devices like Wave XLR or XLR dock, you will have the option of low impedance mode. This is needed for some specific in-ear monitors, also called IEMs. If you are using in-ear monitors and hear some static or buzzing, try enabling this option. If you are using typical headphones, you can leave this unchecked. Next is the low-cut filter. This is designed to clean up the rumble on audio by removing sound below a threshold. Rumbling can be from road traffic nearby, moving the mouse on your desk, or typing on the keyboard. Depending on the model of Wave microphone you're using, you may have an option for enhanced low-cut filter, or specific thresholds like 80 Hz or 120 Hz. We would recommend experimenting with toggling enhanced low-cut filter. For Wave XLR or XLR dock, 80 Hz is a great default to start with. In fact, this voiceover was using the 80 Hz option on XLR dock. Clipguard is our proprietary anti-clipping technology. In essence, you can yell or scream into the microphone and your audio will remain clear and clean. As Clipguard does not affect how you sound, there is never a reason to disable it. Clipguard is available on some Wave models, such as Wave 1, Wave 3, Wave XLR, and XLR dock. And finally, Wave Gain Lock prevents voice chat apps from being able to adjust your microphone gain automatically. These apps try to help by raising or lowering your gain as you speak, but this can impact your streams and recordings. We recommend leaving this enabled. If you use Stream Deck Plus, you can add your existing third-party microphone by clicking on this left gray section. You'll then see a selection of input channel templates. And scrolling down will show your input devices, which could be USB microphones, XLR audio interfaces, or even a sound card in your computer. Third-party microphones and inputs can't have their settings controlled by a Wavelink. For controlling their gain or volume, you will need to use Windows or Mac sound settings, or the software that came with that audio device. Stream Deck with the Volume Controller plugin can help though. With Volume Controller, you can control the hardware gain of that third-party microphone and its headphone port, using the input device control and output device control actions. Learn more about Volume Controller in the video linked below and up in the video card. Now that your third-party microphone has been added to Wavelink, it can now be mixed with all your other inputs and app audio, ready to be used in streaming or recording programs. And as a quick summary, to use your third-party microphone in other apps when using Stream Deck Plus and Wavelink, make sure to use Microphone Effects as the input for your software. Microphone effects can include audio effects like compression and equalizers, and even soundboard audio. On the other hand, Stream Mix is able to include all audio inputs and is better suited for use in apps like OBS Studio. To learn more about Elgato Wavelink, check out our Wavelink playlist linked in the description. This series covers topics like mixing and routing app audio for your stream, adding audio effects to enhance your microphone and voice chat, or using Stream Deck to control your audio with ease. Thanks for watching.